So the danger, if you're not cleaning up your studio and you're working with toxic stuff, is you may be protecting yourself by wearing a dust mask, but it may be getting on your shoes, and then it's getting in your car, and it's getting on your carpet, and you may have kids at home. And kids are not small adults. They're down low, they stick everything in their mouths if they're toddlers. If your carpet's contaminated, there's a chance they're going to get exposed. They're a lot more vulnerable than us, especially to lead poisoning if they're under the age of 6. And we see kids with a lot of diseases now at a very young age that we just see a lot more of it. And it's not just because we're better at diagnosing it. There's actually just a lot more kids with asthma and autism and leukemia, ADHD than there used to be. The National Institute of Environmental Health Sciences is estimating that at least 70% of asthma case, or autism cases may be linked to chemical exposures. The one thing we know does not cause autism is immunizations. It's one of these things where correlation does not equal causation. So it just so happens that the age at which we can detect autism in behavior is the exact same age that we give kids immunizations. Just because it happens at the same time doesn't mean it causes it. And we have really tested it to see if it causes it. And there's been no evidence at all that there's any source of autism from these immunizations. So coming from the Agency for Toxic Substances Disease Registry, which is part of the National Institute of Health, they're basically saying all kids in the United States are at risk of lead poisoning. It can cause serious long-term problems. And there's no level that's safe. It's wholly preventable. So if you're in an area where there's a risk of lead contamination for kids under the age of 6, getting annual blood lead level testing is something we recommend in King County. When they go in for their immunizations, have them take a little sample of blood and run a total blood lead level. And then these are the numbers that we're looking at. If it's over this, we actually send a public health inspector out to visit the family and try to figure out where the heck the lead's coming from. So you can have studio clothes and home clothes and avoid contaminating. Clean your studio up. If you're going to vacuum, use a HEPA filter vacuum. That'll keep the dust trapped in the vacuum and wet.